वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चरर पार्ट 5 ऑन द फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल. सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सिंपल बार प्रॉब्लम एंड हाउ टू फॉर्मुलेट द स्टिफनेस मैट्रिक्सेस एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व फॉर इट एंड हाउ टू डिटरमाइन द नोडल डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स स्ट्रेसेस एंड रिएक्शंस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. सो इन द टुडेज क्लास वी हैव टेकन द एग्जाम्पल नंबर 4. That is the worked examples on stepper bars. Okay, so consider the bar shown in the figure. An axial load P 200 kN is applied as shown. Using the penalty approach for handling boundary condition, do the following. First, determine the nodal displacements, determine the stress in each material, determine the reaction forces. So this question has been asked in twice in the VTO examination for 20 marks. A very important question it is. Questions of this kind will be asked in the examination. Okay, right. So area and Young's modulus for a first section, that is aluminium bar, is given, and area and Young's modulus for the steel is also given, and force is applied here which is of the magnitude 200 into 10 to the power 3 newton is given, and the lengths of the two aluminium and steel bars also been given. Next, you need to find the displacements, stresses and reaction forces by the method of handling the boundary condition, which is penalty approach. So in the previous class we have discussed about elimination method. How you had done the elimination method? Whenever the displacements are known at the fixed supports, we have eliminated that particular row and particular column, and we have solved for the displacements. But here it is not like that. Even though we know that the displacement at the third node and first node is zero, then also we need to find the displacements. Means minute changes will be there here at the support, that we need to find out with the help of penalty approach. Okay, so now let us see how to solve this problem. So here the given datas, all whatever the datas are given here, they have taken here. And first step is to FE model. First step is FE model. So they have modeled like this. See, as it is a stepped bar, as I have explained you that location of the nodes. Okay, where to locate the nodes, wherever the fixed supports are there, and where the load is applied. And definitely here geometry discontinuity is also there, as it is a stepped bar. There is a geometry is discontinuing, as well as a load is given here. So at this point definitely you need to take a node. Even though the load is not applied here, you should have taken the node here, because there is a geometric discontinuity. Okay, so that's why there are three nodes here. So first node, second node and third node. So definitely the displacement here is q1, here is q2 and here is q3, and the force is f1, f2 and f3, but only f2 is given, f1, f3 are zero. Okay, right. So next step is to find out the elemental stiffness matrix for both the elements, one for aluminium, another for steel. Okay, fine. So as we know the formula, a stiffness matrix for a bar element is AE by L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so let us find out the elemental stiffness matrix for a first element now. Okay, with the given data of this particular element, that is this aluminium element, let us find out the stiffness matrix by using these two values, AE and L is here. This is the length of the element. A is the area of an element, E is the Young's modulus for a aluminium bar. Okay, let us substitute here. Okay, so for a first element, aluminium bar, it is area, this is Young's modulus, and this is the length of the element, and the stiffness matrix, that is 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So after getting the value here, 10 to the power 6 is outside, 0.56. means what? 0.56 into 10 to the power 6 you will get. That 0.56 is multiplied within the matrix. Okay, So you will get this one. And here the displacements are q1, q2, q1, q2. Let us name them. And these are important. I will tell you why it is. Okay. So these are the global degrees of freedom. Okay. It has a 2 degrees of freedom, one at each node. So next element. For the element number 2, steel, you have a stiffness matrix like area. Now you need to take the second areas, right? So here, A2, Young's modulus 2, and length of the element is this, 400 mm. Fine? Okay. So now, here, okay, area, Young's modulus by L, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. So now it is 0.3 into 10 to the power 6 you will get. That 0.3 it is taken in the within the matrix. Okay, like this you will get. And here the nodes are q2 q3 q2 q3. You can see here. Okay, for the second element there is a q2 and q3. Q2 q3. For a first element it is q1 and q2. Fine. Okay, now. Now the very important thing is to get the global stiffness matrix. So this I have not explained in the previous video because it was a single element. There was no need of getting the global stiffness matrix. But now there are two stiffness matrix here, one for aluminium, another for steel. So you need to combine them. How to combine them? So that is given by, see here. Listen carefully. This is the first row. Okay. First row, first column element is 0.56. So here, first row, first column is 0.56. First row, second column is this, minus 0.56. So first row, second column, minus 0.56. But first row, there is no third column. Here, third column is there, but there is no first rows. So this is second and third row. That is why it is zero. Got it? So first row, third column is not there in both the matrix. Hence, you need to take 0. Then, second row. Second row, first column we have, that is minus 0.56. So, minus 0.56. Then, second row, second column is 0.56. See, second row and this is second column. So, this element is 0.56. And even though here also you have second row and second column. So, you need to add these two values. 0.56 plus 0.3. You will get 0.86. Okay. Then coming to second row, there is no third column here, but here is a third column, second row and third column, which is minus 0.3. In the same way, third row, first column, here there is no third row, third row, there is no first column, so it is 0. And we have third row, second column, third row, third column. Just note it down. So once we get a global stiffness matrix, and next step is to find the displacement vector and load vector. Displacement vector is q1, q2, q3. Okay, there are only 3 nodes, so one displacement at each node, which is q1, q2, q3. Then global force vector, f1, f2, f3. Here the load is given at the center point, right? 200 kN. So that is why f2 is this one. F1 and F3 are 0. Next, equilibrium condition. So K into Q is equal to F. This is the equilibrium equation. Just put K, then Q, then F here. Okay. So K into Q is equal to F. Next step is going to be very important, that is applying the boundary conditions. So one more thing is that if it is by elimination method, we would have eliminated first row and first column, then third row, third column, because the first and third nodes are fixed. But this is a penalty approach. We need to find like this. Okay. So here what you need to do is you need to identify the maximum value in the stiffness matrix. Okay. In this stiffness matrix, what is the maximum value? That is 0.86. Okay, you need to 0.86 into 10 to the power 6. This also you need to consider. Okay, 0.86 into 10 to the power 6, that is multiplied with 10 to the power 4. Okay, what you need to do first, you need to identify what is the maximum value in the stiffness matrix, then you need to multiply 10 to the power 4. So total you will get 8.6 into 10 to the power 9, I think. Okay, 6 and 4 are 10. Okay, 8 is 9. So that value you need to again multiply, you need to add to the first row first column and third row third column. So why you need to add in these two points only is that wherever the nodes are fixed, okay, here the node 1 is fixed, okay, that's why you need to add this value to the first row first column. Then third node is also fixed, that's why you need to add here also, that is third row third column. So here 10 to the power 6 is taken outside, only 10 to the power 3, remaining 10 to the power 3 into 8.6, you will get 8600.56. So this value and this value you need to add, and rest of the values are remains unchanged, okay, no need to change any values, only where the nodes are fixed there only you need to take them. After that, global force vector, see there is no change, don't change anything here, just keep as it is, this F vector just keep as it is, okay. Then the equilibrium equation can be written as like this, that is K into Q is equal to F. Then you need to determine the values of Q1, Q2, Q3 with the help of calcium. Three equations, three unknowns, from that you will get the value of Q1, Q2, Q3. And one thing you can able to notice that the maximum displacement is taken at the node 2, okay, where the load is actually applied, it is applied at the node number 2. And we know that Q1 and Q3, that is node 1 and node 3 are fixed, right? So you should have got the value 0 for the fixed nodes. But here you can see 15.1432 into 10 to the power minus 6 mm it is. Means very very negligible. It is of the order in terms of mm, right? And that too, this value to 10 to the power minus 6 mm. Means very very minute value you will get at the node 1 as well as node 3. So these are the displacement vectors or displacement values you can say, okay. Then you need to find the stress in each material, right? So stress formula is what, E by L minus 1 1. If you want to find out the stress for element number 1, this is Q1 and Q2. See here, Qi plus 1 means if I is equal to 1, this is 1 and this is 1 plus 1, 2. Q1, Q2 you need to take. If you want to find out the stress for element number 2, here Q2 and Q3 you have to take. Okay, so that values are given here. Yes, E by L minus 1, 1. This is Q1 and Q2. Fine. So first you need to multiply this into this value, this into this value. After then, add them. And whatever the addition value you get, that you multiply with this term, then you will get 54.26 megapascal. Okay. Then sigma 2 is also same. After multiplying, adding and multiplying, you will get minus 116.6 megapascal. Okay. Then reaction forces. Reaction force formula is minus C into Q1. Minus C into Qi. Qi minus Ai is also okay. Anyway, Ai is 0. Simply you need to take minus C into Q1. Reaction will be there where there is a support. So first node, the node number 1 is fixed. Hence you need to find out the reaction at the first support, which is minus C into Q1. What is this minus or C? C is the maximum value of the stiffness matrix. That is, just now you have found out, minus 8.6 into 10 to the power 9 multiplied with the Q1. So whatever the answer you have got, Q1 displacement, that you need to multiply, then you will get this value as the reaction force. Okay. Then reaction at the node 3, minus C into Q3, minus C, and this is Q3. So after multiplying this, you will get minus 69.76 into 10 to the power 3 newton. So this is the way you have to calculate a particular problem with the help of penalty approach. Okay.